Hey, good morning, guys. Matt DeFeedy with Realty Executives Elite Homes in Nutley, New Jersey. And this quick little video I'm putting out this morning is going to tackle some of those first-time home buyer fears. Now, I always tell my first-time home buyers when I sit down and consult with them and work with them, and if you are thinking about buying a home, you should sit down and, you know, interview a couple of agents and see how you feel about them before you commit to them and start working with them. I always advise that. The other thing I tell my first-time home buyers is you're going to get a lot of advice from all different areas. You're going to get advice from your parents. You're going to get advice from friends. You're going to get advice from people that never, ever have bought a home before or have never bought a home before. So my only suggestion there is to, number one, when you go to meet with your realtor, bring a list of questions that you have with you. This way you can go down, you know, what are these fears, what are these pain points that, you know, bother you or keep you up at night or stopping you from purchasing a home. I think one of the biggest fears with a first-time home buyer is when they sign an offer paperwork, they think that they are locked in to that contract. Now, here's how it kind of works. Here's how it does work. So you're out with your realtor, you find a home you like, you want to put an offer, you write up an offer paperwork, it's called, and that becomes a contract, but it doesn't become a contract until an attorney reviews it. So the attorney is going to review it and protect your interests right off the bat. So then again, you should use a really good real estate attorney. And most of the time, your realtor can suggest someone that they work with and knows the process and works rather quickly, unless you have somebody you already work with. The second hurdle and the second question I get, well, what if I buy a home and there's a lot wrong with it? It's going to cost me a lot of money. You know, what if I buy a money pit? The second process of that transaction is first is the offer acceptance and then the home inspection. Home inspector, a qualified home inspector, is going to go in there and point out the issues with the home. Now, at that point, you can either decide to cancel your contract or work with the seller to remedy a solution. And that usually comes in the form of a credit or a repair, one or the other. Then the third question I always get is, what if I buy a home and the value is not exactly what I'm paying for it? What if I'm overpaying for it? The good thing about that is if you're getting a mortgage, and even if you're not getting a mortgage, I would suggest an appraisal. With a mortgage, an appraisal is 100% mandatory. Without a mortgage, it's up to the buyer. But my advice to all my clients, even buying cash, is, hey, you know what? You should still do an appraisal. Pay the $300-$400 to do the appraisal, and that will, you know, take care of any issues with values and so on. So those are the three top things. If I sign that piece of paper, am I committed? Number two, what if I buy a home that has issues and it's going to cost me a lot to fix? Number three, what if I buy it and the value is not there? So we have a whole process, and if you are a new home buyer and you're looking to purchase a home and you need to sit down and talk to somebody, even if you're not buying right now, you know, set up an appointment with me. I'd be happy to spend an hour or so with you and go over the whole process. I'd love to educate you on how the whole thing works and demystify the whole experience. My next video I'll do it on mortgages, and then we'll talk about that. Have a great day, guys. Matt DeFeedy from Realty Executives Lead Homes. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.